That concludes the 2020 NHL Draft. Thank you. Be safe and be healthy.
I think with the picks we've made over the last day and a half, we're headed in the right direction.
Lastly, Bo, what do you think free agency, like what type of needs do you think could be addressed by that when the market opens Friday?
A goalie. We felt we needed to improve our goaltending. We wanted to find a guy that really fit well with us.
It's stopped by Talbot.
When we started talking about Cam, everything that we found out about him and knew about him was that he was the perfect guy. In free agency, we found our guy in Cam Talbot.
Keller in alone, and a save by Kakkonen.
We are also really lucky to be able to develop somebody like Kaapo Kakkonen.
Pass across, nice save by Kakkonen.
We've had him in the system now for 7 years. He spent a good chunk of time in Iowa. He was goalie of the year. Kaapo came in and took that position. He didn't come in and just kind of dip his toe in the water to see how it felt. He jumped in with 2 feet and took the job.
He robbed McKinnon from point blank range.
The goalie's going to have to come up with one or two saves a night to keep us in the game. And every once in a while, he's going to have to steal a game.
To Kolasar, and what a save by Talbot.
We've seen that from both our guys this year, is that they've stolen games for us.
Now on the rebound, Kolasar's denied again. He robbed him twice in a matter of seconds.
He's got to give us a chance to win every single night. It's a luxury to have, and we feel we have it.
The first two drills involve you guys playing the puck.
Yeah.
So work on your footwork, okay? Don't just go back there. Work on your footwork. Make sure you're looking up ice. And let's make good trespass. Have fun. Have a good day.
Yeah. Come on, buddy. What's going on? I need a drink.
My name is Frédéric Chabot. I'm from Lac-Saint-Jean, Quebec. My baptized name was Joseph Léopold Louis-Marie Frédéric Chabot.
Love.
Yeah.
Here. Blocker.
Yeah.
I guess I fell in love with the game or watching it on TV, watching the Montreal Canadiens from the 70s. Somehow I fell in love with goaltending. I was mesmerized by the goalies. I started out playing forward and D, and I would spend half the games making save for the goalie. So they finally let me play goal. I was pretty good at it, so I stuck in goal.
Tim LeCage, two margin shot, Chabot Kinesi.
When you get to the post, I'm going to step out and try to shoot.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, still the same game. I think it's the training, the coaching has changed.
Yeah, go.
The intelligence of the game and the skills and the talent, that's it's still the same. I think we are better trained as athletes and better coach, and the game has gone a long way. It's a lot faster than it used to be.
Good stick, Kaapo.
Yeah, thanks.
In a season like this where you have to roll both guys, not many things better a team can have than two goalies that are rolling, and it doesn't matter who you put in every night, they're going to give you a chance to win.
You follow them in practice or games or whenever, is just doing the right things every day and taking care of his body.
Hey, great job, bro.
I don't think I could work out as much. I'd just be so sore all the time. But yeah, he's a beast. He's got a great work ethic for sure.
When I went to college, actually, I wasn't the fittest goaltender. Anyone that was on my college team will tell you that. My freshman year, I was a little bit overweight.
A guy like him to become NHL number one goalie had to acquire along the way work habits and discipline and how he took care of himself. He became a really good college guy, signed with the New York Rangers. And his work ethic and his, how he takes care of himself, how he prepares, that's why he made it to the NHL and he became a number one, and he's at 34 still playing really well.
Come on, Capo.
What was that?
That's a good save.
I mean, for a young goalie coming in and being able to do what he's done so far this year, you know, that's not an easy thing to do. To step in and play four or five games in a row when I was hurt there, and then do it again when I got COVID. So his approach to the game at such a young age and his calmness out there, I think he gives the guys a ton of confidence.
It's been a steady progression. Like, he came in from Finland and he played well pretty much right away, but he had to get used to the intensity of the practices here and the travel.
I haven't played in the NHL for that long, but I've still played professional hockey for almost 6 years now. So you kind of learn that when it's your job, you got to do your job, right? No matter where it is. So I think that experience kind of helps me.
Nice save, Goalie. Hey,
yeah, thank
great
you.
Job. Hey, wait a minute. Oh, you're always in position today. Good job.
Thank you. Nice moves, dudes.
Good stick. Last time we did this, it was a tough day on the goalies. Oh, nice, Dom. The old kick save. Oh!
Lucky.
All goalies, I think, they may look different to you, but they all do the same thing. Everybody's trying to score, and the only thing we think about is keeping the puck out of the net.
Oh! Jojo, see what you got. Oh! Good patience.
We have very little margin of error, so I think that's where the personalities are different. A lot of goalies, players think they're cheap, they don't spend their money, they're used to saving everything, so so they try to save their money too.
Hey, I had to let you score so we could get the hell out of here.
Oh my God, that's it. Good day, buddy.
At the rink and in games, it's awesome. It could be any better, obviously. But off the ice, it's kind of a different world we're living in right now.
It's been a little bit of living in a suitcase, but we've been on the road so much that it's been the same for every guy almost. Like, we're just constant packing and unpacking. I think the coaching staff has been doing a great job. They realize, you know, we play every other night. We need rest too. This year, especially, it's not going to be perfect every night, but just finding a way to win the games that are maybe not going your way, or maybe, you know, there's stuff that happens that you can't really control. Just find a way to win is the key, I think.
Tonight in St. Paul, it's the Wild and Golden Knights. Capo Kakinen, we're going to get him starting in goal tonight for Minnesota, Tom.
Yeah, that's a big plus for him also. He's playing with confidence.
Kakinen has six consecutive wins. Vegas, as a team, have six consecutive wins. Something has to give tonight here.
Okay, here we go, guys. We got Moose.
Oh.
Rose. Greener.
Hey.
Me.
Oh.
Suits.
Oh.
Captain.
Hey.
Couple.
Hey. Holt back after it for Vegas. Takes a hit from Greenway.
There's Cody Glass getting the line off now for Wah. Wah for Kolesar with a shot. Out to challenge, make the save. That time was Kakinen.
Out to center, Carrier. Spun around by Susie.
Sends it ahead now, Fiala. 2-on-1 with Parisi. Here's Fiala cutting in, takes a shot, he scores!
It was a game that it was just grinding. You know, it was a low-scoring game. We were up 1-0 for pretty much the whole game, and it was just tight.
Pacioretty fires and a save by Kakinen.
Down the left wing side, pass across. There's Haig with a shot. Nice save by Kakinen.
In those situations, in those tight checking games, you can kind of feel it coming down the stretch and you hope for it. But until that buzzer goes, you never really know. So, special moment for him, I'm sure.
2-0, the final for Minnesota.
I'm not going to say this is lucky number 7 for Capo. He was fantastic tonight in shutting out the Knights.
The win streak that you're on, is this the best you've felt in your career?
I don't know if it's best of my career. It's tough to compare. I probably sound really boring on these interviews, but it's just the daily work, I believe, that matters. And, you know, doing those little things right, and that will get you there.
I still think everybody else likes to talk about it more. I don't really care if it's a shutout win, 1-0, or 6-5. It's, you know, it's 2 points, and it's all that kind of matters to me.
It was a huge game for us too, so that just plays into his calmness, his demeanor, and the way he approaches a game. I mean, that was a huge moment for our team, and more so for him. First thing I did was look across the ice and skate across and grab the puck from the ref for him, because obviously that's a special moment, and I remember someone doing that for me, so I had to do the same for him.
He gave me the puck and he just said congratulations, and yeah, he was just happy for me, and it was a cool moment to get that puck for him.
All right, we got the bucket. I think the guy deserves it. He's played hard all year. His first shutout in the NHL. Yeah!
Hell of a game, guys. Great team effort, and let's keep it going.
How was the body today?
Not bad. A little tight to start. Loosened up at the end.
Goes up high to Ferraro. And back to Meyer. Winds and fires. We get a whistle. 58 seconds left in the Sharks' power play. Talbot really moving gingerly in the Minnesota crease right now.
Looks like he went down and from there really didn't feel great.
The injury was really a bad luck thing. You always want to get in the groove and get going and feel good, so it's easier to get into games. And that wasn't easy for him this year because he's had to deal with different things that stopped him.
Just 2 games following a lower body injury, Cam Talbot added to the COVID-19 list. Boy, you talk about a rough start to a career here in Minnesota. That's not the start Cam Talbot was looking for.
I felt like I started as well as I could have hoped for with no exhibition games or anything like that. And then, yeah, third, fourth game into the season, you take a puck off a bad spot and you miss 4 or 5 games and then come back for, you know, 3 or 4 and again, and then you're off for another 21 days. So it was extremely frustrating for me. I don't like to miss time. I'll play through most injuries that I'm capable of playing through, but now I've been able to settle in here in the last month and a half or so. And you know, I feel like I've been playing some of my best hockey in my career here.
Starting on goal, number 33, okay.
Let's go, Tom.
Let's go, Tom. Come on, Ekdiesel.
Garland centers. Sliding save by Talbot. Kessel's in again. And another save by Talbot.
I'm healthier than I've been in the past few years. I think the team in front of me has a lot to do with it. There's a lot of trust that goes into playing behind a group, and I've trusted this group from the get-go. It makes my job a lot easier.
Tuck is in, saved by Talbot.
He seems to be getting in the groove, and it's fun to watch.
Flips the defense, saved by Talbot.
Is Sam landing? Where's Dad?
Right here.
My wife is Kelly, and we've got 4.5-year-old twins, Landon and Sloan.
I think you guys need to cheer louder for Dad to hear you.
My kids absolutely love coming to hockey games. They miss the family rooms and being able to hang out with the other kids and stuff like that. The fact that they can still come to games and be a part of it is huge for not just me, but for them as well.
Most of the game, after like they've seen him, they'll be like, ask a million times, where's Nordy? Like they will search and be like, where is he? Oh, he's over here. And they will run around like just like looking for him. He says hi from Nordy. He says hi, Landon and Sloan. I don't know. Whoa.
Hi, Nordy.
I spent my entire life trying to stop a puck, and it's definitely not easy, but trying to take care of twins and keep them out of trouble is definitely harder.
Face-off tonight at home ice against the St. Louis Blues.
They've got the break, and it's a much-needed mental break, but they've got to find a way to stay focused 60 minutes. It's a hungry Blues team.
O'Reilly to Kyrou, center to Perron, and what a save by Talbot. Krug in the middle for Schwartz, across Tarasenko, glove save by Talbot. Make it 11 in a row here in St. Paul. Cam Talbot with a 37-save shutout.
Yeah, just how much do you think the team can use these 3 days off? I mean, obviously you guys are winning almost every night, but I mean, this has got to be a grind right now.
It is a grind, yeah. We're definitely in need of these days off.
we'll take a couple of days to regroup here and come back Sunday ready to practice and put the work boots back on. We're looking forward to the rest for sure and come back on Sunday fresh.
We're just at park about, you know, 5 minutes away from our house, so we bring the kids here. There's tons of structures and stuff to play on and lots of room for them to get out some energy. This is what we try to do on days off, so it's just, like I said, keep them active, keep them happy, they enjoy this, and it's just good quality time, which I love.
Mom, look at me! Look at you!
This little diva right here is Sloane, and then Landon's going down the slide over there. Twins, they're born 3 minutes apart. What do you want to be when you grow up, buddy?
Nordy!
You want to be Nordy? Is that your answer to everything now? They're like little best friends. They want to do everything together. If one's doing something and the other one sees it, it's just straight to where the other one's gone. Again? Okay. They're definitely connected, that's for sure. Which way are you going?
Is Daddy the bad guy? Oh no. You better hurry, he's coming.
You guys are too fast. Days off, there are no days off. Not with these two. Oh, Daddy needs a break.
What's the trick for taking care of twins?
Have a rock star wife that pretty much does everything. Kelly and I met through her brother, actually. We played hockey together at University of Alabama, Huntsville.
Him and my brother like came to a restaurant we were at, and then yeah, we just talked after one of the games, and yeah, it was like nothing after. He like didn't want to give me his phone number, nothing.
I can't give it up that easy.
So I was just very persistent, and yeah, when I saw him, I was like, oh, I like this dude.
I got a call, I think at the end of June 1 year, and Alabama Huntsville called and said, hey, we've got a spot opened up for another goalie, and it's a full scholarship, and you know, I come from small town and hardworking parents and humble beginnings, I guess you could say, and full scholarship kind of meant a lot, so I just jumped at the opportunity. Not one of the major programs that you think about in the States, but again, I think that's just because it's kind of hidden in the South and no one really knows about it, so you know, hopefully I've been able to bring a little bit of notoriety to the program since I've left. And it actually got on the map last summer again because they tried to cancel the program, and we kind of spearheaded a fundraising program where we had to raise, I think, $500,000 in 4.5 days before they were gonna cancel the program. Within the last month or two, the university itself pledged $17 million over 10 years to keep the program running. So that was pretty special to be able to save the program that gave me my opportunity.
Ready, beat me again. So a normal day, basically the team goes out and practices. Me and we've had, I think, up to 5 players on the taxi squad this year, and we'll kind of do our own practice at the end after they're done and hop in for some drills and basically just trying to stay sharp. For us, it's just important to make sure we're staying ready and doing everything we can to be ready to play if we do get called upon.
So just screen the first two. Wrap it.
Long cycle, wrap either side.
And then
long cycle, hip to D coming.
Yeah.
You look great today, by the way.
I think it's really hard, the job he has this year. It's thankless. He has to work really hard every day to make sure he keeps his fitness up. But you don't get to play, you know. The pleasure of playing hockey is playing games. And he played a couple of scrimmage in camp, and that's it.
There you go, speed time. Okay.
I'm trying to, you know, make it fun for him as much as I can, but still got to be hard on him to make sure we train him hard enough that he's fit and ready to go if we need him. The only way I can relate to that, I was with Montreal in the 93 Cup run, so I spent almost 2 months just practicing, and you're just watching the game, and sometimes you feel a little bit empty, like you haven't done anything.
But the drills we did, there was still a lot of movement.
I felt like the drills were way better today. You have to just stay optimistic. I mean, especially throughout my career, I've seen how quickly things can change, and you can go from not even necessarily dressing in the lineup to being playing the next game.
It's happened twice now in my career where you're kind of the number three guy, and next thing you know, you're playing a pretty important game, and should I get called out of the blue that I'm playing or something? I've done it before, and I know I can do it again, and it's just a matter of the day-to-day staying focused on the things I can control.
Joe Capo.
In 2015-16, I had a career year with Ottawa Senators. That year, my nickname, the Hamburglar, really took off.
No stop by the Hamburglar, who's done it again, and the Sens win it!
To have that much success as we did, that just made it that much better. And the fandom that kind of started then with the Hamburglar made it a little extra special, and something that's continued to this day where when people hear about me, that's kind of the first thing they think of. Dating back to college, it had kind of become a nickname from a drill after practice that we would do. And if I made a big save, refer to the goalie as, oh, he stole that one or something, or thief or anything like that. And then one day someone said, oh, the burglar, and then it turned into the Hamburglar. And when we were painting my helmet that season, we thought it'd be funny to put on there. Once I started playing games in Ottawa, it seemed to kind of take off. And next thing you know, there's people throwing hamburgers on the ice.
He picks up a hamburger off the ice. Throwing hamburgers. Man, oh man. He's taking the burger and he's out of here. He's flipping them to people. Cheeseburger, cheeseburger. What a save.
As a goalie especially, I mean, I want these guys to win as many games as they can. And part of that in my role is that if my name were to get called, that everyone on the coaching staff and the players have confidence. They know I'm ready to get that job done for them.
Having been around and having that experience, I think for a number three guy behind us, it gives the team a lot of confidence knowing that if something were to happen to Cap or myself, that we've got another veteran guy back there waiting in the weeds. So, you know, it's great for the organization to have a guy like that, and he's just been great for us.
Every time one of these guys has a great game, I'm very happy for them and let them know. And in practice, it's the same thing. Whether you make a big save, you're always hearing sticks tapping from the other goalie. And obviously, they both want to play a lot, and they're pushing each other. And I think the team's kind of reaping the reward of that, that they have two goalies that are working so hard and supporting each other. And I think it's just a really healthy relationship.
Saved by Kakinen!
Cabo is just, he's a great goalie partner. He wants to better himself just like I do. We come to the rink every day, and we all just want to continue to get better every day.
What a save by Talbot!
There's no reason for any of us to be satisfied yet, and that's kind of the mentality that we take.
Another big time stop by the Minnesota goaltender.
I'm really excited about what this group can do. When we play our game for a full 60 minutes, I don't think there's a team that can beat us.